Born on May 14, 1657, Sambhaji Maharaj was the valiant successor to Shivaji, leading the Maratha Empire after his father's passing. Despite being captured and enduring relentless torture by Aurangzeb, Sambhaji remained firm in his commitment to Swaraj and refused to convert his religion. He sacrificed his life on March 11, 1689, earning the title of Dharmveer for his unwavering devotion. Sambhaji's courage and strategic brilliance saw him win 120 battles, expanding and safeguarding the Maratha Empire in a remarkably short span. On May 14, 1925, a devastating event unfolded in Nimuchana village, Alwar. Farmers protesting against unjust taxes imposed by Maharaja Jai Singh faced brutal retaliation. The Alwar government, instead of addressing grievances, chose violence, sending military forces to crush the movement. In a tragic turn, bullets rained down on the peaceful protesters, leaving 250 Rajput farmers dead and the village ablaze. This atrocity, likened by Gandhiji to the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, remains etched in history as a symbol of resistance against oppression. Even today, bullet marks on Nimuchana's walls serves as a poignant reminder of the sacrifices made. Every year, on May 14th, the valor and sacrifice of those brave farmers are commemorated, ensuring their legacy endures. On May 14, 2002, Lashkar-e-Taiba terrorists launched a brutal attack on a Himachal tourism bus in Kaluchak, Jammu and Kashmir. Wearing combat uniforms, the terrorists boarded the bus near Samba and mercilessly opened fire, killing the driver, conductor and indiscriminately firing at passengers. Grenades were hurled at nearby vehicles, intensifying the devastation. This heinous act claimed the lives of 31 innocent people, including men, women and children. The Indian Army swiftly responded, eliminating all three terrorists who were identified as Pakistani nationals. The Kaluchak massacre stands as a grim reminder of the ongoing struggle against terrorism in the region.
खानदानी लुटेरों की कोशिश होगी बेकार फिर एक बार मोदी सरकार।
शिक्षा देश का गौरव है और RKDF यूनिवर्सिटी शिक्षा का उद्रम है। RKDF में सवारे अपना भविष्य। PhD MPhil करे अपने पसंदीदा विषय में। सर्टिफिकेट डिप्लोमा के 74 कोर्सेज RKDF यूनिवर्सिटी।
The Ministry offices in Luton's Delhi, Hotel Janapath, as well as airport terminals. Granite Studio India, with its prestigious brands, rich experience, and the trust of our clients, can be your reliable partner. We are here for you, for innovating, processing, supplying, and executing in stone. Contact us today for our special sample kit.
Israel declared its independence on May 14, 1948, amidst a backdrop of regional tensions. Surrounded by adversaries, including recent conflicts with groups like Hamas, Israel has maintained its sovereignty since its inception. The territory was formerly part of the Ottoman Empire, later occupied by Britain, and eventually designated by the United Nations for partition into Jewish and Arab states in 1947. Despite immediate challenges, Israel emerged victorious in the face of joint Arab attacks shortly after declaring independence. The country's democratic journey began with its first elections in 1949, electing David Ben-Gurion as its inaugural Prime Minister. The LTTE, or Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam, is designated as a terrorist organization by India, the European Union, Canada and the United States. It was banned in India after the assassination of former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi on May 21, 1991. Led by Prabhakaran, the LTTE sought to establish an independent Tamil state in northern and eastern Sri Lanka. The organization perpetrated acts of terrorism for nearly three decades before Prabhakaran was eliminated by the Sri Lankan army in 2009. Mark Zuckerberg, born on May 14, 1984 in New York, is the renowned founder of Facebook. He launched the social media platform on February 4, 2004 while studying at Harvard University, initially naming it the Facebook. Its rapid growth saw it rebranded as Facebook. By the end of 2004, it boasted 1 billion users. Zuckerberg's visionary leadership attracted significant investments, making him a billionaire at just 23. In 2021, Facebook Incorporated rebranded as Meta, encompassing platforms like Instagram, Messenger, and WhatsApp.